Hello and welcome back to another episode of Track Talk with Tom Tombadil. Today we have this monster of a race car known as the BMW M8 GTR. Now this race car is usually universally hated or loved. I'm going to talk about a couple of those reasons why people hate it and why people love it. Personally, I love it, of course. Anyway, let's get this thing on to the track and do some track talking. Yeah. Alright. Now, this iteration of the BMW M8 GTE is, powered by a 4.4-liter twin-turbocharged V8, making it quite fast. It is a race car. Anyway, it competes in the IMSA WeatherTech Sports Car Racing. That's the one that races at the 24 hours of Le Mans. It's hard to talk because it takes all of my concentration just to keep this thing going in a straight line. But I'm gonna prevail. I'm gonna keep talking. Look at that! I didn't even shift down for that turn. Anyway, just listen to the exhaust and everything. It's amazing. Everyone loves this car, even if it's, you know, gigantic. And it is gigantic. It is the largest car that races in the IMSA WeatherTech Racing Series, which is why there's so many memes. Like, you can go on Google right now and look for all these memes of this car, where it's like, oh no, there's cars and they're behind the gigantic M8 GTE. And you just gotta see it. You just gotta Google it. Anyway. Turbocharged V8, so very fast. I'm sure it doesn't get that great a gas mileage either. Anyway, this race car is based on the M850i, which BMW made early last year, I think. It started coming out, and that's just a great car. Hold on, let me just change my screen over here so we can talk about the M850i xDrive. Yes, xDrive means all-wheel drive. Okay. Yeah. A little bit in the grass there, that's okay. Anyway, the M850i xDrive is powered by the same turbocharged 4.4-liter V8. Makes 523 horsepower. It's got all-wheel drive, it's got an 8-speed shiftable automatic, it's dual clutch, I know, I've actually driven one before, and it's great, I'll get into that later. Anyway, we are electronically limited to 155 miles per hour in the street-going version of this car. I think that's all BMWs though. Well, the ones that can reach, I mean, 55 miles per hour. Anyway, it's got 14.8 cubic feet of trunk space, seats floor, and the one that I drove was a convertible. Now, I'm not usually a fan of convertibles, but I made an exception for this one. Because the starting price of these is around $112,000, and I'll just take whatever car I can get. You feel me? If it's worth $112,000, hell yeah, put me behind the wheel. Anyway, how I got behind the wheel of one of those things is the BMW's M-Town Tour thing, which is where they go around the cities and they let people drive their super fast sports cars just for seemingly no reason at all, other than to fill up your email with a bunch of BMW spam. In my opinion, it was kind of worth it, because I absolutely love the car. I'll never, you know, be able to afford one, but hey! I'll drive it! Anyway, we're on Watkins Glen right now, just putzing around in our 600 horsepower car. Watkins Glen is it's a NASCAR track mainly. Most people know it's a NASCAR. I do believe the IMSA WeatherTech Racing Series comes here sometimes too. Now that's primarily an endurance racing league. They do 6-hour races, 12-hour races, and 24-hour races. I can usually only sit through like a couple hours at a time when I'm watching those races though, because to be honest, it gets kind of boring. Like, at first when they start and then they're all crashing and stuff, that's fun. And then, you know, the drivers first get out and they're like, yeah, we're badass, we're gonna come out here and do our best for our team, and then it gets to be nighttime. And everyone's like, alright, we have to be safe and not destroy our car. So that's when it gets kind of boring, and then all the camera crews go home. The announcers are just out doing whatever. I mean, they get into some pretty hilarious conversations at nighttime, but it's not too terribly exciting for racing. But then during the end, like, 2 hours left of the 24-hour races, they start to pick back up. Anyway, driving one of these things in real life was a real experience. Well, not the race car version, but the $113,000 one. I'll get back into that. I'll talk about it all day. Like I said, the thing has all-wheel drive, the twin-turbo V8 making 600 horsepower. Well, no, not 600, it's like 525. Whatever I said earlier, that's how much it makes. Anyway, it'll propel it from 0 to 60 in 3.6 seconds. It's unreal. For real, man. Your brain doesn't even have time to think when you're accelerating that fast. You know? You're just like, we're going fast. It's too much fun. I love to go fast. Keep go fast. Yes! Ah! We're keeping it though. I'm gonna keep it. I don't edit these videos. No one edits these videos. I just dribble on. Because it's fun. Oh, we're gonna take this real wide like the NASCARs do. If you ever see the NASCARs run through here, they take that turn extremely wide for some reason. I think it's because they can't get a stop in time. They're just racing their little hearts out. But, yeah. You know, I bet this thing weighs about as much as a NASCAR. Hold on, let me switch back to the... well, the stock one's 4,500 pounds, but this one's 2,756. So, yeah, I think it's pretty close to, pretty close to a NASCAR. Did my desktop just flash there? I hope I don't have anything embarrassing on there. Whatever. Let's keep going. Let's keep going. We must press on. I'll finish off this lap, and then we'll call it a video. So I'm running out of things to talk about. I think for the rest of the set, I'll just keep talking about my experience driving it, at least. I didn't get to play around with many of the features inside, but I know that there's a shitload, because there's like some freaking buttons around. Like, oh my god. This button overload. Like, what does this do? What does this do? And they're like, no time to explain. Just get it out on zero. Hold on, I'm gonna do a German accent real quick. No time to explain. Get it out on zero so we can get the next person inside this MHPC. And I was like, yes, Hans, I will get this thing out right away. I had a blast just terrorizing the city. And my M850i. Like, you can hear when I get out of the car like that, and it makes that. That is true. That is true of the road going version too. It is so much fun just to make that sound at people at like stoplights and stuff. Like, hey, what do you think you're doing? You could try and race me, your BMW man. Oh, he's gone. Yeah. Anyway, I wanna call it here. Thanks for watching or whatever. Let me know what you want to see next, because I don't know. I'm just making these. Someone said V8, so I was like, alright, we'll do V8. Okay. Bye.